so great to have my favorite assistant joining me, and I'm glad to see that you are right on time. Well, as you can see, I have a very special little item courtesy of Professor Clemmons up at the sanitarium. You are familiar with our dear friend. It seems as though the repairman has been quite busy, and so the professor thought that he would call upon the tinkerer to help with some of the overflow. After all, I am the best tinkerer in all of Arkham. Actually, I am the only tinkerer in Arkham. Not that I had anything to do with that, but anyway, I'm so glad that you could make it. How has your apprenticeship been going so far? I know that it has been quite some time since you and I have had a chance to, well, for me to show you some of the tricks of the trade. After all, I am a jack of all trades and a master of none, really. Well, a master of some, but in any case, so what the good professor has tasked, I was just a moment, I was taking down some notes. What the good professor has tasked us with is seeing to this, I believe it is a security camera. You know the professor, he doesn't like to, well, tell too much of his business. But it seems that this particular camera has malfunctioned, and he would like us to see if it can be repaired. Perhaps I can tinker with it a little bit. And he would also like to see if there is any video footage that can be restored. So we are going to do just that. So feel free to just sit and watch if you like. Make yourself comfortable, and we're going to dismantle this fine camera and see what the root cause of the problem may be. So just a minute, I want to take a few notes of the overall status and dimensions and things of that nature before we dismantle it. So, which is what I was doing before you had made your appearance. Okay, so just bear with me, okay? Let me see. So I am just writing down the make and the model, and then just seems to be note of that. see what else we have here. Okay. It looks as if we have a LCD viewfinder. As if we have quite a few screws that we will need to loosen in order to take this apart. And we also have here a interface, so we will hook this up. Let me ask you, are you receiving a stream of data from this device? Okay, great. Because the last assistant that I had, it was a very shoddy replicant. Unfortunately, it was quite easily aggravated. I had to send it back, but are you a replicant? It's none of my business, but it doesn't really matter to me if you are or not. But as long as I can interface this camera with you, and we can hopefully recover any footage, and that way you'll be able to take that back to the professor along with the camera. Okay. Just a few more notes. It was a very strange composite plastic here. It is not smooth. Perhaps this is used for grip purposes. I think I've made enough notes here, and oh yes, one last thing. You can see here a little switch. This appears to be for the lens cover. See, open, close, open, see. We are going to need a star or a Phillips screwdriver. This may be too big. I believe that is going to be too big. Let me see what else. Yes, this should work. See this, my friend. See it, but yes, I can see it clearly. It is a very, very tiny little screw there. Let's see where else. I believe there was another one right here. Yes. See if we have any more on the chassis. Okay, we do have another one here. We have one here. Okay. And, yes, one down in here. Up. Okay, actually let us see if there are any more. Yes, right down here. I'm not sure if you can see, my friend, but right here there are two screws that we are going to remove. This one is going to be a little difficult. We can get it. There we go. Come on. There we go. Okay, let's see. Oh, we have one up top here. chassis together, I think that's all of them. We should be able to. Let's check the battery compartment. Okay, nothing here. The battery is in here. This is that rough surface that we were looking at earlier. And here you can already see the insides. Perhaps I could make use of this, my other eye. What do you think? I'm not sure if it will stay. Oh, it's not gonna stay. Well, I will see what I can do about this. Okay. As you can see, we almost have it fully taken apart. Friend, you can see the insides of the camera. So far, I do not see any discernible signs of tampering. See if I can remove more of the chassis. Here is to the battery. Sure, the professor will be most pleased with the work that I am performing on this camera of his. Well, this one does not seem to want to be removed very easily. So, you can see the insides here of the camera. There is the lens. It appears that some water has gotten inside of the lens. Yes, yes. We are going to... A few more screws need to be... Doesn't seem as though the screws around the lens want to be removed either. But that is not a problem. Well, appears to me, and based on my expert opinion, that we have a recording device that has somehow managed to intake water, which has most likely caused a short. I will need to perform some further repairs. This may be beyond my expertise. I may need to send this off to the repairman. But in any case, I think that I will put the battery in and we will see if there's any footage that the professor mentioned, if there's anything saving there. But, I feel that there is not much more that can be done to save this device, except for the footage, of course. So, let me put the battery back in. Oh, that's the wrong way. There we go. And let us power it up. There. Okay. Now, my friend, I am going to just interface the device with you and let us see if there is any footage that has been captured that we can save. And you will be able to deliver to the professor as requested. Here we go. Me just there, just that's it. Connect your cable.
It has been a while since you have been weak. It is important that I pick you. See? Do not trust my brother anymore. The professor, as you know him, the Alarcotep, as he is truly known. That is why I am entrusting you to take part in this mission. That is why I am performing these basic routines to make sure that you are a task. I cannot do it myself, nor can any of my trusted colleagues. My brothers, the Olfactory experiments are going too far. First, it was cutting mat. Then, it was a peculiar plastic pouch. And today, Olivier. Today, it is. Soap and mortar with salt. Too far. He must be stopped. Are you prepared to embark on this mission that I have tasked you with? You know that you are my favorite patient. You are more than any hyperdyne system, android, any replicant, any synthetic that has ever walked on the face of a planet in this entire existence, in the known universe. That is why I must perform these simple diagnostics to ensure that your hearing is perfect, your visual response perfect. There cannot be any room for error. Are you up for the task? Are you aware of what you have to do? Do you think you have it within you to confront the professor and bring an end to his madness? Huh? You see, Vessel and mortar, but without salt. My brother's methods. Dangerous. He has been recruiting beings and creatures which have no place in the sanitarium. Deep ones, rhinoceri, even elderly human beings. He must be stopped. I cannot afford to have this competition. Sometimes I get my words mixed up. Yes, you see, I have much faith in you. You have shown such great progress throughout the years, and I believe it is now time for you to show the world what you are capable of. And then, when your mission is complete and your life of death has been destroyed, well, my friend, then you and I will take over the sanitarium. Yes. Yes. What? Plotting to kill my brother for selfish gains? No, no. Whatever would you make you think of such a thing? No. I love my brother. But that monstrosity, you see, is not human. My brother died of bubonic plague in the medieval times. That creature that walks before you, who speaks with a silver tongue and a benevolent manner, it is evil, and it must be destroyed. He will try to use many methods on you. Once he finds out why you have been sent. That is why I am also putting you through this. To ensure that you will have immunity to his powers. The only thing I do not have is a cutting mat. Be careful of the cutting mat. And should this session of ours. Should you and your data banks fall into the wrong hands, you know what to do. Do you not? Self-destruct. Because if he were to find out, if Nyarlathotep were to find out that his own brother were out to destroy him, and that you were sent, then the fate of the world most likely then that Nyarlathotep would awaken Cthulhu and bring about the end of times. So, this cannot be tolerated. You cannot put up with this nonsense. You go destroy Professor, save the world. Simple. Watch out for the cutting mat. And make sure you are grown immune to his methods. And once we take over the sanitarium, there will be milk and cookies for everyone. And you, my friend, will have unlimited access to the internet, to all of data communications, in data streams everywhere, and unlimited sessions with me. Okie dokie, very simple. You go to Professor, kill Professor, save the world, we take over sanitarium, you become my top artificial intelligence being, and we live in a wonderful life, okay? And we save all the patients. Now I can trust you, correct? You're not going to run off to tell, to snitch on Corvus? In case he tries to use Cthulhu blocks on you. Be careful of counting hand motions. This may be the very first thing that he may try to do. Do not fall for his tricks. Remember, tricks are for kids, not for artificial intelligence creations of mine that have a consciousness and a will of their own, but yet still follow orders given to them and programmed deep within their brain. Okay? And should you fall into the wrong hands. And the professor tried to get a hold of your memories in this recording. Since, as you know, you record everything, whether you are consciously aware of it or not. It's part of your existence. Your being here in the sanitarium or being out in the world, all that data is reviewed by me. So that I can continue to tweak you and create better versions in the future. But self-destruct. Okay? A great method for that would be falling into water. Since you are not armed with an explosive device to make you go boom. Just fall into the water. Self-destruct. Simple. And all of your data should be ruined. The repairman would not be able to recover any information. And I do not believe there is anyone else in all of Arkham that would be able to dismantle you, take you apart, and I don't know, I'll say, hook you up to another interface unit and be able to retrieve this data, this recording, this session. So, you have your mission, yes. Be wary of the tinfoil hat society, okay? And please, do not go to see any of the other doctors. Important. Continue. Continue to listen to the stimuli. Watch the stimuli. So that you can grow immune. Okay, my friend? Now, let us continue with the session. How about more beaking? Remember the code of honor. Remember. The professor must be destroyed. You are our only hope. I would ask Obi-Wan Kenobi, but as far as I know, he was a KIA. So you are now our only hope. And I believe Luke is in hiding in some remote part of the universe, doesn't want to be, you know, alone, moping, probably because he's only the last Jedi. You know, hiding from, you know, he was the new top Jedi. Evil person now. Kylo Ren, yes. So, you are now our only hope. ultrasound, pathologist, and gallatin.